Luke 12. Verse 19 to 21.
I won't preach long things.
That's legitimate.
I just want to pray for you. I don't know how I can tell you this.
It's a uncalled to visit a cow, Muhammad.
Verse 19 to 21. Can I read for you? That's why you'll understand my message. And I say, I will say to my soul, so you have made good things stored up enough for many years. Rest and relax. Eat, drink, and be merry. Or celebrate continually. But God said to him, you fool, this very night your soul is required of you. And now, who will own all the things you have prepared?
Amen.
Can you see that?
Amen.
Let's pray. Father, thank you for your word. In Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
If we look at this story,
you
will understand that Jesus began to speak it like a parable. The parable of Jesus was, people are busy preparing themselves to have things. And those things are useless. And there's something very important in you. That is your soul. Our soul is important. Just your soul is important. If you can read there, you see this parable of this man who reached a level of saying, I have enough now. I need just to celebrate until I die. You realize that all his labor time was spent in story. That eating what is
perfect.
I learned that many times we are so busy with things that will never enjoy them, and we forget to prepare for our soul. Not long I found that many people who work hard for things, those things they never enjoy them. And it's only someone who never worked for those things will come and abuse those things. Whatever we work for is not forever. This world was possessed by someone. Where we are, it was a stand of someone. This shows that we are wasting time when we try to fight for things that will never last. God wants us to prepare for our soul. Because our soul will be there beyond those materials. This man is a typical example of the people who are busy with things of the world than living life to please God. Jesus says, A fool is a person who demean his soul by other things. Many times, because of the outward appearances and the things around us, they mix us not to have good interpretation of understanding what is in us. Many times, people of the world, they judge you by your surroundings, but not by someone in you. If we prepare for our soul, we show that we are wise. If you read Mark 8:34-37, Jesus was saying, if you wish to follow me, deny yourself. In other words, endure whatever that may come. In other words, the importance of these things is to understand the things in the world that they must not contaminate your spirit. In other words, whatever you see outside of your soul is not so important than your soul. Whatever is there that can make you to deny yourself for Christ, those things are there to make your soul to suffer in hell. In Luke 15:7, it says, when Jesus was showing that, he said, the only one soul can change the atmosphere. When that soul repents. In other words, our souls are so important. At any times, we don't see the importance of it. And when God looks down, heaven looks down, he's looking on our souls, waiting for the change that you can bring to your repentance. This scripture, verse 7, shows that heaven is looking down. Because there is a joy in heaven when one soul on earth repents. Meaning, heaven is looking down. We are a subject of discussions in heaven. When people talk in heaven, they talk about us. There is a joy in heaven. Think about how many times we disappear in heaven. The Bible says, joy in heaven when one sinner, one soul, repents that 99. This shows that God does not go by the number. God looks at your soul because God is not a respecter of men. I was looking at that, I found that if we are called Christians, we need to be careful because God is looking at the soul that repents. If you read Luke 10:20, Jesus was saying to the disciples, I have seen you casting demons and you are excited. Be excited that your names are written in heaven. Listen, the activity we do on earth does not matter anywhere. If we are not subjected to the rules of heaven, and please deliver me. If you read here, the Bible says, the disciples were excited, we casted demons. There is more than that. You can still cast a demon, and your character does not show repentance. You are still as somebody who is not even saved. And Jesus said, be happy that your name is written. Listen, this does not mean casting demons entirely to heaven. Jesus was saying, casting demons, everybody can even try to do it. And then later you find you have to be determined. by your repentance.
Saula sukulu o sukulu yena.
I'm here to tell you that.
Shere kile tano se che.
We've got many activities.
Wana ni mifani mito le miche.
That we are doing.
Yere iti na.
But the question is.
Ana puche bote ase.
Are we really saying that our souls are important?
Wana ni ayer na kio na mtu ya buto mana.
If truly we are seeing that.
Aha ni tita na yere iwana.
In our churches, we won't have a problem.
Ikele kutare na waga sibele mutara.
Nobody will push you to do something in the church.
Awa mutaka wana leta uyo diya sese mento mwana.
If we see. The importance of your soul. There is no preaching that will push you. There's nobody will push you to
do it.
You'll be ready for your pastor to preach to you.
You'll
be ready to obey your
Lord.
Do you know why Christians sometimes are pushed to do things?
Yes,
they don't understand. They don't even understand
at
all. The church that will understand the importance of this soul, they can even give all they have to God. Because they know very well that it's not what they possess, it's what is in them that matters. There's no money that can be equivalent with your soul. There's nothing on earth that can be equivalent with your soul. So therefore, if your soul is important, nobody will push you to pray. If you see your soul is not important, there are things you will do, and you will keep double from today, because you know that you are doing this preparing for your soul to have rest. If you believe, shall come out of here.
Out of here, hallelujah.
One of our challenge today is Christians who don't know why they're in the church. Others, they feel like they have been manipulated in the church. Others, they feel like when they do things for church or for the pastor, they are just making him favor. If you understand your soul as important, there is nobody who can be able to stop you. When you move, you can spend the whole night praying because you understand that you are sowing something in your spirit. You understand that you are not just doing this. That's what the Bible says. Your labor is not in vain in the Lord. Many Christians today, they don't know why they are in the church. Can you ask your neighbor? Why are you in the church? Allow your neighbor to tell you. So he tells you, why are you in the church? The reason why we will spend eternity in
hell
is because all chances were provided for us to live in a
life
and play with it. The moment you get an opportunity to find yourself in a church or to repent, there are things that nobody will tell you to stop. You just stop when the person says the important that is you. If your soul is important, You won't be pushed to tell.
Fokasa pele chuo.
Pushed to be.
Fokasa pele chuo niel.
Pushed to come to church.
Fokasa pele chuo reta kereke.
You won't be controlled by the blessings.
Fokasa taule kadi chuo fatu
na bicho
kereke.
You can hear Christians say, I'm going to church, I'm not saying anything. You are not seeing anything.
What
about your soul? If you are not seeing your soul, you are as good as your dead. Why the Bible
said,
he is unto me. Is greater than the one unto
the.
It's the courage. Of saying,
I
see a challenge, but as long as God has seen my soul, I can still continue, even when it's a hard to continue, because God has sent
my
soul. One of our challenges today is we want to see something. But we understand, we forget that this something important. The Bible says the soul that sinned will die. If you understand that, you understand that you need to deal with yourself before it comes
there.
God is not respected
of
men. He wants you to deal with yourself before he comes. He won't push you. Someone will just prophesy and bless you. Your friend come and rob you. Many pastors are disappointed. Because they don't even know where you're going. Where you're coming from. But I'm here to tell you, if we can have Christians who are saved, I don't care any blessing. I don't care what is happening. If you want to bless me, you will bless me as church. I'm not going anywhere. I'm staying where I am. I will serve my God. When I'm hearing bad, I tell my pastors, I don't mind. Better than the word of God. Many of you, you are even comparing us. Can you see Makanisa? Can you see it's like that pastor? Can you see it's like that one? But let's go to the scripture. You can't compare this blessing. In your soul you are empty. In your soul you are
rested.
In your soul you are
proud.
I'm here to tell you,
that's why
the reason of poverty here people are forgetting to seek God first.
Simple is
seeking
God.
And all shall
fall.
We need to have a church where prayer is like food. We need to have a church where you are not pushed to go. When I look at you, some of you, you've been in this church, in that church, in that church. But when we look at your spirit, you are nowhere. He's coming back.
Where
are you going to spend your eternity? Because you judge yourself by comparing yourself with others. I want to tell you something that will really shock
you.
I think I'm the only person who can tell. Christianity is not a beautiful car. It's not money. It's not business. It's not marriage. Christianity is not what you are searching for. When Jesus died, he didn't die for your car. He didn't die for your job. He when Jesus died, he died for your soul.
When Jesus died,
he
died for
many times, we are making mistakes. I'm praying with pastors. When they come to me, they want their church to be like the church of
their Lord.
When they come to me, they want to be a prophet. When they come to me, they want to be a prophet. I've been praying for them. It's only when I was in America. I even tell
Prophet Emmanuel.
I said, all pastors of Ethiopia, when they come to me, they say, please, I just want my relationship with Jesus. Others, they open my eyes.
Blind.
I found these pastors. What I need now is my relationship
with
Jesus to this person. I'm telling you, there are Christians that will leave this place from tonight. That when they reach to their church,
they
will be unstoppable. Sometimes you must ask people of age. We'll tell you, we never thought we would reach this age. And by the time when they were leaving, there were cars that you never saw them driving.
No one had the colour to ever see about 12 hours and when they did the lead one of the
listen to this. All these things will pass.
Dear feet, your pasta, dear feet.
All will pass. But the word of the Lord
will
in your spirit will never pass.
That is 2015.
I decided to tell you
that.
I decided to tell you. All people, you are still being used by God. Somewhere, somehow, they reach a level of no return. They say, There's nothing I need now.
How said I'm doing in your camera?
Except to Jesus.
Come down, Lord.
Except to Jesus.
Come down.
There's a level.
When I listen,
but when you reach this,
so that house,
you just say there's nothing I need.
House and I'm drinking.
Except in Jesus.
Come down, Lord.
If you're not reach that level. It's Jesus and
Jesus
and the
goose.
Jesus and the car.
Jesus
and the car.
Still behind.
Yeah, you must reach a level.
Where
you are low.
Lord, I'm out
and rejection is
everywhere.
You are low. And you are possible. You are low. And there's nobody standing with you. If you reach that level, you are a that's why today, because people are not valuing their soul.
That is why, but you don't know how to talk about it.
They can fight pastors. When now cases happen to them,
you are only two people to fit them.
They say that pastor is a witch.
And that
case has happened for them to repent. That is why many people today, their Christianity is, when things are tough, Jesus is not God. Many even today, they don't see the importance of others because they stand up. Because they don't know it's inside them. Your soul is important. It's important than your education. There are things you can do. And people call you stupid. But because you know what you're doing, you carry on doing your
work.
Your soul is important than your position. Don't complain about anything. Just concentrate in what God can do. And carry on it away that save your soul. Take your word inside your spirit and carry on meditating day and night. And one day is
Monday.
And that day is
today.
And the Lord will never leave you. Today, I see your breakthrough. I see your success. I see your life. I see God changing everything around you today. And if you can shout out to me, sit down. I say your soul.
I will let them
my
well in.
My one step.
Say, hey. When I say
breakthrough,
I feel breakthrough.
Hey! If now I say, I'm just praying to the prophets of Charisse, you people of
Charisse.
That, you know, when we prophesy, we speak everything. Just pray that you speak everything. If you didn't sleep well, sir, you are not sleeping well. This and this. God loves you. You need to repent. Look at Shida. What is happening? You are giving a lot of money to the church. Even when you don't sleep well, there is no prophecy. Because our matters are focusing on things, not in Him. That's why the church,
that is why
today, you can be surprised. The choristers are singing. The ushers are singing. Everybody is doing what
they're
doing. As long as you're
not
even
here,
shut up. is what is happening here.
In twenty yana manajwale.
Is what is happening here.
Ki twenty yana mo.
Is what is happening here.
Ki twenty yana mo.
Here what is happening here.
Twenty yana mo.
You can take somebody's husband.
Oka eh. Oka chali mama uchomo.
And you can't be a worshiper.
Ah, what are you saying? What are you saying?
Is what is happening here?
Get out of here, dear man.
As long as I've got people,
as long as I'm allowed to get again,
I'm afraid to tell them.
Stop
doing this.
Because
they believe. If I'm standing here,
I can't
remove. Because I don't care